Hey, this is Beelzebozo, and this is an installation guide for OS X Mavericks using UniBeast 3 and MultiBeast 6. UniBeast is a tool that creates a bootable installer out of your downloaded version of OS X. So you'll need access to the Mac App Store. You'll need to access that from a functional computer running OS X Snow Leopard 10.6.8 or later. So I'm going to now show you how to download the OS X Mavericks application, prepare a UniBeast USB flash drive, install OS X Mavericks, and install the bootloader and drivers using MultiBeast. If you don't have an account, you'll need to register at tonymacx86.com, get the latest MultiBeast and UniBeast tools from the download section, and you'll need to use a USB drive of 8 GB or more. So OS X Mavericks is free. Apple is basically giving it away. So if you're running Snow Leopard, Lion, or Mountain Lion, you can download it for free from the Mac App Store. So what you'll need to do is open the Mac App Store, log in, and download OS X Mavericks. I've already downloaded it, and it's currently sitting in my Applications folder. So once it finishes downloading, you can see that it'll show up there. You can launch launcher. And then what you'll need to do after that is create a bootable USB drive using UniBeast. This is a pretty simple process. All you'll need to do is just kind of pay attention to what you're doing. So you'll need to insert your USB drive, open the applications, utilities, and then go to disk utilities, and then highlight the USB drive in the left column. So my USB drive is titled Untitled, and I've gone ahead and selected it, and now I'm going to create a partition. Next, I'm going to click on Options and select Master Boot Record, and click OK. I'm making sure that it's selected to Mac OS Extended Journaled, and I'm going to put a name to it. I'm going to call it UniBeast, and then click Apply. And as you can see, formatting the USB drive with this utility is pretty simple and straightforward. So you'll now want to get a copy of UniBeast 3 from the download section. Once it finishes downloading, you'll want to run it and click continue, 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 and agree. You'll want to select your UniBeast USB drive. And as you can see, one of the great enhancements to UniBeast 3 now is the ability to install either OS X Lion, OS X Mountain Lion, or OS X Mavericks. So you'll want to choose the OS X Mavericks option. Another thing that you'll want to do is drag MultiBeast 6 for Mavericks to your completed USB drive. Installing UniBeast does take about 15 to 20 minutes, more or less. So I've gone ahead and fast-forwarded this part of the video just to cut that time out. Alright, UniBeast is done being created. And as I said earlier, what you'll want to do is get MultiBeast and drag it into your USB drive. Once you're done, you'll want to take a look at step 3. And the description for recommended UEFI settings. Next, I'll go to step 4 and install OS X Mavericks. All you need to do is boot from the USB drive and install. Next, you'll want to power on your PC and boot to your disk boot menu. Select the USB drive that you used for UniBeast and hit enter. If all goes well, you should reach the Chimera boot screen. You'll want to pay extra attention to step 4 of the guide. If you have trouble reaching the installer, you may want to type -x at the boot screen as shown in the screenshot. Depending on your system setup, you may need to enter a combination of boot flags. Since I'm familiar with this system that I'm installing on, I've gone ahead and just entered -v. And that bypasses the Apple boot screen and enters the verbose setup mode. For further explanation of boot flags, there's a link on the guide that you can read. So I've gone ahead and arrived at the installer, and I'm going to choose my language. Next, you'll want to go to the top and select Disk Utility. For new installation of OS X, you must erase and format the destination drive according to the following steps before continuing. So you'll want to highlight your target drive for the Mavericks installation on the left column. Click Partition tab, click Current and choose One Partition, click Options, choose GUID Partition Method, and then under Name type Mavericks. Under Format choose macOS Extended Journaled, click Apply, then Partition, and close the Disk Utility. Then it'll take you back to the installer and you can choose your formatted drive to install. Once it's done installing, you'll want to restart the system. The install succeeded. I went ahead and fast-forwarded the installation process because it does take about 15 to 20 minutes. So to save time for this guide, I went ahead and cut that down. Your system should now restart, and what you'll want to do is do the same thing that you did at the beginning, is boot to your USB drive, and select with your arrow your formatted drive that you installed to. At this point, you may need to use one of those boot flags. With this system, I went ahead and just hit enter because I know that it does work without having to boot in verbose mode. And it should reach the desktop. I'm going to go to step 5 now and use the post-installation optimization using MultiBeast. So I've gone ahead and reached the welcome screen. And I'm going to go ahead and go through the setup process for this Mac. Great, so as you can see, I've gone ahead and reached the desktop. Booting after the install was a complete success. So now I'm going to use MultiBeast to optimize my installation. So what you'll want to do is open and run MultiBeast. Now there's three options to the quick start. You can choose EasyBeast, User DSTT, or DSTT Free. You'll want to read each of those descriptions to know more about them. Next, you'll want to click Drivers for audio, graphics, and network options. You'll want to click Optimize for further options. And one great new thing about MultiBeast 6 for Mavericks is that you can print your settings or you can save them to backup for your configuration. So if you ever need to run your configuration again, you can load it and it'll basically go through the whole process all over for you. So if you go to Quick Start, it'll list the three options on the left-hand side. The first one is EasyBeast. The next one is User DSTT, which you can use to also include a customized DSTT install for your system, and the DSTT Free option. Next, you'll want to go to Drivers and select your custom audio and any other custom drivers that you need for your system. You'll definitely need to select a audio text and a networking text since they are not bundled into the quick start option. Next, it'll show you which version of Chimera it's going to install. So it's going to install the latest release version of Chimera. And then you'll see some additional boot options, DSTT options, system definitions, and themes. So as you can see, whatever is going to be automatically installed is already checked off. So what you'll want to do once before you click on build is save your option settings. If you click the save button, it'll save that to your disk. And then you can retrieve it at a later time if you need to do this all over again. So once you click on build, it'll show you all the options that you've chosen in MultiBeast. You'll click on install and click on agree. Enter your admin password. Alright, the MultiBeast install succeeded. And I'm going to go ahead now and restart my system. If all goes well, I should be able to boot from the hard drive now without having to use UniBeast and reach the desktop straight forward. Great, so I was able to boot from the hard drive and reach the desktop. At this point, what you'd want to do is go around your system and make sure that the internet works and that your audio is also working. Those are really the other two options and are not included in the quick setup. So before I finish, I'm going to show you how I was able to save my configuration to the disk using the save option in MultiBeast. So the configuration that I used before, I was able to load it up again, and it's all listed there in the current configuration option. So again, that's a great way to not have to mess around with MultiBeast too much if you need to do another fresh install. All you need to do is find your configuration, load it, and it'll do everything that you did before. So that's it for this guide for OS X Mavericks using UniBeast 3 and MultiBeast 6. I'm Beelzebozo. Thanks for watching.